There is a big difference between health and the look of your teeth. Now, when it comes down to health, it really comes down, just like your gut, to the quality of the bacteria that are in your mouth. If I'd said this to you 50 years ago, people would have closed down right now. But I think most people understand that your digestive health is the key to your body, whole systems being healthy. And in your mouth, it's the same thing. You need to have a healthy balance of bacteria in your mouth for everything to function properly. And when it's so cool, because when your mouth is healthy, everything works the way it is. Your teeth will remain strong. They will not get cavities. Your breath is fresh. Your gums stay healthy. They don't bleed. They stay where they are. You don't need a lot of dental work. You don't need a lot of cleanings. You don't need anything. You're just happy, healthy mouth person. And I want to explain to you, first of all, what that looks like bacterially, and secondly, how do you achieve that? Bacterially, and we have talked already about planktonic bacteria that float like little cells in the liquids of your mouth, and we have contrasted saying that that's just 20% of your mouth bacteria, and that the big 80% are different. And in a healthy mouth, the difference is that these bacteria are all healthy, or they are a mixture of healthy bacteria woven together with strands of proteins that come from your saliva, and they weave together these bacteria into a mat or film. It's translucent, you can't see it. It is not plaque. It is healthy biofilm. And it covers not just your teeth, which is where plaque grows, but it covers everywhere. It covers your tongue. It covers the skin on the inside of your mouth. It covers the roof of your mouth. It covers the inside of your lips. It covers everywhere, down your throat, up into the back of your nose. It lines your sinuses, every part of the inside of your nose, your throat, the back of your mouth. Everywhere is covered in healthy biofilm if you have healthy mouth and hopefully a healthy nose. And the two are connected. So if you're struggling with allergies and sinus, when I talk about xylitol, think about maybe getting a xylitol nasal spray. And I'm not the ENT person here, but your nasal health is connected with your mouth health. Healthy biofilm is different. It is this matting. It is, can we call it the skin that covers your teeth? It's very thin, you don't feel it any more than you would say, as you rub your tongue over your teeth, that your teeth feel slick, they feel almost waxy, they feel comfortable. And why is this? Well, this is because healthy biofilm is actually our defense. It's protective. It protects our teeth from the things that happen in our mouth. Every time we eat and drink, there are temperatures. Maybe you have an iced margarita or you have a boiling hot cup of coffee or soup. Your cells of enamel and the delicate part of your tooth inside are protected by the skin of your teeth, by this barrier of bacteria woven with proteins that makes this healthy biofilm. So it defends us from changes in temperature. And if you lose healthy biofilm by using artificial whitening products, or you use peroxide or baking soda, they are really good at dissolving the proteins, releasing everything, so you have no biofilm. If you've ever been to the dentist's office and they cleaned away all the biofilm off your teeth, often you'll go home and if you have something hot or cold, you will feel the temperature. Your teeth will be sensitive. So biofilm is protective. It protects us from temperature changes. It protects us from chemistry, from chemical things that occur in our mouth. If you have spicy food, if you like really hot peppers or curry powders, they can be very spicy. And some of them, the chemistry of that is quite harsh for your teeth. And your teeth will stain from it and be more at risk of more permanent staining if you have lost biofilm. In a sense, this biofilm, this protection, protects us from the chemistry of things that go on in our mouths. So I work really hard with people to develop healthy biofilm. Protection, protection, protection. It also protects people from infection by cavity-forming bacteria. If you have a healthy layer of this healthy biofilm over your teeth, the bacteria in biofilm have friends. They actually form communities within the biofilm, and they reject the bacteria they don't like, that are not like them. And if you have healthy bacteria that like the healthy environment you have created for them in your mouth, they will reject those acid-loving, damaging, plaque-forming bacteria. So they do the work for you. They keep your mouth healthy. The other thing that this healthy biofilm will do, it'll stop your teeth from being abraded, from being scratched and damaged. Too much today, I hear dentists suggesting you use a really soft toothbrush because you're going to wear your tooth enamel away. You're not going to wear it away if it's coated in healthy biofilm. You could wear it away if you're using a baking soda in your toothpaste, if you're using a peroxide artificial whitening powders. These are the things that will strip your teeth of this protection. And then, sure enough, that you leave your teeth, your enamel, at risk for abrasion, for toothbrushing. But if your mouth is coated in this healthy biofilm, you don't have to worry about that. You can use a toothbrush that's more resilient, that's more able to help you with your mouth health. So this is why healthy biofilm is so important. It is your defense against the things that could harm your teeth. How do you develop it? Well, you have to develop it in a slow way. There isn't an instant way. Take a pill, take a probiotic, some kind of dental probiotic that people like to sell, and that is marketing to people who don't understand this. If you take a dental probiotic, little bunch of new bacteria, chances are your biofilm is going to reject them. You may be spending a lot of money unnecessarily. What you have to do is create the conditions that will change the biofilm. The biofilm likes to be in a place where your mouth is moist. It doesn't like to dry out. This is why having something like xylitol, if your mouth tends to be dry, it will stimulate a flow of saliva. If you talk a lot, I talk a lot. I need xylitol to stimulate new saliva to come into my mouth, and then it will help protect the biofilm. It will help it from getting dried out. It will keep it moist. That is what you want to do. Somebody who has Sjogren's or has had chemotherapy perhaps, or radiation damage, and they have less saliva, xylitol is such an ally. It's so helpful. The other thing you can do is avoid long periods of acidity. Soda, coffee, sparkling waters, these things are all very acidic. And if you sip them, which we all tend to do, but if you keep sipping them over extended periods of time, never letting your biofilm recover, you're just keeping your mouth constantly acidic. It can modulate or push, tip the scales, whatever you like to think of this. Nothing in biofilm happens in a hurry. But if you can keep tipping your biofilm in the right direction, it will go that way. So it is nudging your biofilm that's important, modulating it, slightly changing it, little by little, day by day. And you either take it down the road of health with your good habits, little bits of xylitol, long periods of not eating and drinking, maybe an hour after the xylitol, all of that is going to help modulate your biofilm in the right direction. If every day forget Dr. Ellie, I like my lemon juice, I like to sip it, I'm gonna have my protein shake, I'm gonna sip my coffee, I'm never gonna stop nibbling, eating, and drinking. Good luck to you. Your biofilm will be constantly nudged in the wrong direction. And the unfortunate thing is, you may not see the results for 5 to 10 years. It's that long. Sometimes you can get away with it, but I'm telling you, turning it around, if you work at it, 2 years is usually a good time frame to allow. If you're somebody who is used to having cavities, plaque buildup, you have infected biofilm, bad breath, any of those things should go away completely, like a memory from the past, within 2 years. You can speed it up. You can speed up the process by this good habits that you create for yourself. My complete mouth care system is designed to speed up the process, possibly to make it 12 months quicker. Keep a calendar, take photographs, see if your teeth don't get shinier, healthier, your cavities start to go away, that you don't need fillings anymore. And one word here, if you do have a lot of fillings, fillings attract the bad plaque-forming bacteria. It's just a fact. If you have sealants, they're made of the same plastic, you still will attract harmful bacteria to the edges of sealants. This is why I argue that sealants are not the answer for stopping cavities. They block the holes that the cavities might form, but your plaque bacteria will still be in your saliva and they will be attracted to the edge of the sealant. And if you have those in your saliva, you are going to end up eventually with a filling. So changing your biofilm over fillings, over over any sealants, over anything in your mouth that you've already had done is vital. Otherwise, you're just going to need a replacement of that filling, of that sealant, of that crown, of that implant. They're just going to need replacement in 10 years' time if you don't do the work to change your biofilm. And I hope I made that clear. There is a way by changing your bacteria that are floating in your mouth. That is the quickest way. Xylitol is an incredible tool. That will slowly modulate the biofilm that is coating your teeth. They are two separate groups of bacteria. And try to understand that mostly dentistry, I've heard naturopathic doctors talking about mouthwash, killing all the bacteria in the mouth. That is ridiculous. It is ridiculous. You may have washed away the planktonic bacteria for a little bit in your mouth. It's all going to come back. You can't change your mouth that quickly. Don't be scared by these people who do not understand the difference between the ones that are attached to your teeth, that are part of our whole body system. 40% of those develop during childhood. They don't go away just because you rinse your mouth for one minute or 2 minutes a day. That is fear-mongering by people who do not understand biofilm. And I know it's a little bit complicated, but I hope I have made this easier for you to get a hold of so you feel empowered. You can enjoy oral health, even if you have a mouth full of fillings, because we don't care. It isn't about the fillings. It's about the liquids and the bacteria in your mouth.